Hello, and welcome to our next coffee shop chat with friends. I have with me today Rick Nayton and Katie Knobel, and we are here to discuss the enduring principle of responsible choices and why we think it is an important enduring principle for Community of Christ. So, Katie and Rick, who would like to begin?
I'll go.
Okay.
Why is the enduring principle responsible choices important to Community of Christ? The initial sentence that I can add to that is our choices are a impact and reflection on God and our relationship with God. It's just that simple to me. Anything that we do in our choices not only reflects on God and our relationship with God, but it impacts and reflects on our family, on our friends, on our community as a whole, on our church community, and on ourselves. And so making good choices or making responsible choices, that impact to all of those, but most importantly to our Lord is really where it stands with me.
Okay, yeah.
Well, and I think going a little deeper than that and just thinking about how God doesn't want us to make responsible choices because he's trying to ruin our fun. He wants us to make responsible choices because that's what's best for us. And I remember back to my teen years up until I'm now almost 50, how my mom always talked to me about how God wasn't saying don't do this or don't do that because it wasn't fun. He just didn't want us to have fun. He was trying to protect us from doing things that would harm us and harm our community or our family as well.
Well, responsible choices are the choices that we make are derived from and developed from social norms, societal norms, and all of those things. And so those norms come out of a relationship that over time has been developed with God in mind and Christ in mind. And so I don't know that it has. I agree with you in that God isn't trying to take away our fun. He's just trying to enhance our fun by allowing us to stay within some norms that have been developed over time through Him. I think our enduring principle of responsible choices ties into our other enduring principles, and specifically, I can name, the pursuit of shalom. God wants justice, reconciliation, well-being, and wholeness for all of us. So the choices that we make tie into that. He wants the blessings of community. He wants us to uphold the worth of all persons, and the choices we make in that in that play into that. And how we how we treat our creation is important. God said in the beginning, God created and called it all good. And what we do in our choices now really impacts whether or not God will continue to consider it good and whether we can consider it good. And we have challenges before us that lead to that. And it's the choices that we make in the future that will lead to that.
Yeah. Well, I'll admit that this is probably one of the hardest enduring principles for me. Not because I disagree with it, but because there's a that personal like integrity and authenticity like response to it that I know that I drop the ball on it so many times. And I know that I consciously do that, right? That I don't always make the best decisions that are for the earth, or that maybe that always lift up the worth of all persons because maybe I support a company that doesn't have good business practices. There's stuff like that, and so it's an important, I think, enduring principle to filter life through, and then recognizing that we have to give ourselves some grace at times too, but still strive to do better.
Well, the cool thing about it is we can give ourselves grace, but God gives us grace all the time
Right,
that we can work out of that and work, work within that.
right,
Back in the 70s, and you guys probably don't remember that, There was a book that was written by Gail Sayers, and the name of the book was I Am Third. And I read that as a young man, young boy, really, in the 70s. And I kind of held to that from my ongoing life. And you know, I Am Third meant God is first, others are second, and I am third. And I think if we make responsible choices, or if I continue to make responsible choices in and around that motto or that saying, I think I can stand proud a little bit of what I do. Not saying that all of the choices are putting God first and are putting others second, but I find myself striving for that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and at the same time, sometimes the responsible choice we have to make is putting us above others too. Like there's sometimes, you know, there's, you know, cycles of abuse where people get into this putting themselves, you know, last or whatever that they we have to. So there's also that part of it, you know, I think as well to keep in mind that we, you know, responsible choice is sometimes saying I have to put me before you at this point, so that and sometimes it's so that I can then respond to you or something like that. But
yes, self-care is important.
Self-care is important, yeah.
Because we sometimes do get into that cycle of putting ourselves last, and then what happens is we burn out, we overwhelm ourselves. We're not able to serve.
And maybe, yeah. And maybe that's where the lens of the other enduring principles come into play. Like, am I honoring the worth of all persons of me, of myself, and of others as well? Like, you know, and I think that's what's so cool about the enduring principles, that every single one of them is like a filter for the other ones, you know, which kind of gets to what you were talking earlier, Rick, about, which I think is so, they help keep each other in check as well, in a way. So
yeah, they're definitely tied to each other.
Yeah. Well, I want to I think we'll end with that. And thank you both for joining me today for this coffee shop chat with friends moment for the Community Connections Worship. Our next coffee shop chat will be in 2 weeks, as we will talk about unity and diversity with some new friends. And as you can see there, we're ending on at the note of Rick not making the responsible choice of using a mug that is a Seattle team, but a San Francisco team instead. So I'm sorry, folks, but there's a little a lesson moment for you. So thank you both for joining me today for this. Have a good day.
Thanks, Sean.
Bye.
Bye, Katie.